Do you know that the heart of men has doors? Hello? Do you know that the heart of men has doors? Yes, sir. Please come, my brother. This gentleman, come. Look at this man. Do you have some money in your pocket? Let me give you some. Watch this. Just watch this. Hold this. Now, this guy can have money. Hold it. I can stand here. He feels like blessing somebody. But because, although I'm close to him, there is a door that I'm not seeing. Because that door is closed, he will never favor me, even if he's your father. Have you seen, listen, I'm teaching you deep mysteries. Have you seen people who, it looks like your brother, your sister is charmed. They are building a house for another person. They are blessing other people. You are here saying, please, my school fees is just 30,000. The man wants to help you. He doesn't even know why he's not helping you. I'm interpreting it for you today. Listen, proximity does not mean a door has opened. Believe what I'm telling you. You have a neighbor for 5 years. He has not checked to see whether you ate today. No, sir. There is a door. You can even hug. How are you? Good morning, sir. You are this close, yet this far. Because the door is closed. Are we together? I want to travel abroad. And here is someone who has helped 50 people to go abroad. And you are here, you discuss with him, and he says, let's pray. Oh Lord, help this person. And while you are going in his office, he's inviting another person to help him. I tell you why. You are close to him, but your door is closed. You can sing a song, powerfully received from heaven, even put it on YouTube, and wonder why everybody passes it. Because there is a door that closes it. You can open a company. I deal with furnitures. Apostle, I bring all my furnitures from Turkey. I bring them from Italy. Congratulations for your diligence. My question is, I know you have gone across borders, but is your door open? Apostle, I'm a man of God. I fear God with all my heart. I have paid my dues and paid my price. Nobody is placing a demand on my grace. Every time they use me to invite someone else, when will my own grace speak? Sorry, do you know that man? I want to invite him. Another person said, do you know that man? I said, are you aware I'm a pastor too? Listen, I hope you are not offended by what I'm teaching you, because this is a serious thing. If this door does not open, we'll just end this conference, but nothing will change. But if that door does open this night, my brothers and my sisters, you will marvel and wonder. I hope you realize the parable we read. I cannot get up and bring you what you want, not because it is not available, but the door has been shut. The moment this door opens, I can be in America, this man can be in Brazil. Believe me, when that door opens, he will look for me. If it means to travel, he will come here and say, I felt led to bless you. Otherwise, you will keep getting offended at people who are close to you and wondering why they are not blessing you. I'm giving you the explanation now. Just because a man is looking at you and is aware of your need does not mean spiritually the door is open. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Do you know hands can be laid on you, but the door that opens you up to receive the anointing can be closed? The anointing only enters a vessel that is opened. Is it in your Bible? Just because you are a vessel does not mean you are opened. You can be closed. A prophetic grace comes and it's like pouring water with a cup inverted. So you keep receiving prophecies, you keep receiving words, and wonder why it does not happen. Hear what I'm telling you. And the words are true, yet it does not happen in your life. This is your blessing. God has already instructed it. You have seen it in your dreams. You've seen it in your visions. You've even seen the person who is the helper. Yet the door is closed. You will come and tell him, sir, please, it's just to zinc my house. With 1 million naira, I will be done. And the man will say, I'm sorry, I need to travel for a meeting. I will attend to you. Right there, he's wiring 30 million to someone and say, let it be a privilege, please. In 2018, you told me about your zinc. Let's see. Remind me again. And between 2018, he sent over 10 billion to others. And you are close to him. You meet during Christmas. You meet during Easter. You meet every time. But the door is shut. Just because you have someone's number does not mean the door is open. You can call. How are you? Okay. It's all right. You'll hear from me. And that's the end of it. That conversation at a point will come and mock you. But let your door be open. Listen. Joseph was in prison. The door was closed. Someone came out and was with Pharaoh and promised to attend to him, but added 2 years to his suffering. But when the time came, it says the king sent for Joseph and they brought him out of his dungeon. How about Jesus, the Son of the Living God? When he was in the tomb, they rolled the tomb and he was there. When it was time for him to resurrect, the first thing that happened was that an angel came from heaven, rolled away the stone and sat on it. That means I'm sitting on it. Let me see who will close this door. Listen. That God opens a door and sits on it. Now the Savior could come out. You can resurrect and still remain there because the door is closed. Ask Lazarus. Lazarus! Before you will call him to comfort, he said, roll away the stone. Tonight we are going to roll away some stone.